Greetings, YouTube. This is the Hero of Tomorrow, and welcome to a first for my channel. Yes, for the first time, I actually have someone else with me when I'm doing a food review. This is Katie, aka Gigglescar, and we met like 2 years ago at this point, and at my previous job. And basically, because I'm moving, I thought that I would do a special video to commemorate it, and what better way to commemorate that than by asking her to try strange things that I found in Kroger.
But it's like, here, taste with your mouth, taste the wonders of what Georgia can produce for you.
I mean, okay, so like I said, this was basically me seeing what else I could find from the Super Kroger in my area, and I managed to obtain a few things that I was kind of curious about. There are some sodas, and there are a couple of other things too, but basically, I have this lunchbox here that's full of soda to keep it cold, and the first thing that we're going to try today is. I saw this when I was looking at previous entries for the Hero of Tasting, and what I have here is Hubert's Lemonade, but it's special blackberry lemonade. Hmm. So I haven't actually had any Hubert's Lemonade before now, so I'm just so I think I have a regular one. I have a regular one in there too. So just for variation's sake. I haven't been very kind to blackberry on the Hero of Tasting so far. It hasn't actually it's black cherry. Black cherry hasn't really produced drinks that I like, but I do like blackberry pie, so I'm guessing maybe we could try something out here. Okay. So this is Hubert's Blackberry Lemonade. And since you're the guest, I'll let you try first.
Aw, thank you. Even though I hate lemonade. I hate lemons, I hate lime, but I'll try it. It's just a blackberry lemonade.
Sorry, I didn't know that.
No, you're fine. I was going to do this anyway, regardless of the flavors. Okay.
I'm sorry. I had no idea that she doesn't. I'm going to cut that out.
No, you can leave it.
I'm sorry, I really had no idea that you don't like lemons that much.
I could taste the blackberry, but... No! Leave it in the... I didn't know it was going to spew. Did you get any on you?
No.
I just did this. I was
like... You directed it away from me, thankfully. Alright. So let's see. Yeah, it's not very good. I mean...
My reaction was totally more explosive, and you're just like, so monotone about like, no.
Like, I don't hate lemonade like you do. I mean...
I just fucking hate lemon. There is a game.
Well, fuck.
We'll just exit. We'll just, ignore it. God, this video, like, first you got lost, and then we're like, we tried to do it in the car. It was probably a good thing we didn't do it in the car, because it would have gotten all over your car.
Yeah. And then there's, like, the GPS in my phone just hasn't been working the past few days, so I had trouble getting back to the previous city I lived in, and which is, like, 20 miles away from the city I moved to.
So, yeah.
Yeah. So, it's... basically been one train wreck after another with this video. I don't know why we're still filming this.
Because we're just like, we're very stubborn individuals, and we're very determined.
Yeah.
We're like, we're gonna do this fucking video, damn it.
Yeah, I mean, well, getting back to the actual drink, I mean, I know you don't like lemons, and thing is, I'm very particular about my lemonade. I like my lemonade to taste more sweet than lemony. So, combine that with blackberry, which is a naturally sour taste, the two flavors kind of clash a little bit, and it's really not that tasty, in my opinion. I mean, my reaction is nowhere near as explosive as hers was, but...
It was bad. It was like... It tasted like someone put the drink in a side of boot and they just let it fester there in the hot summer days of Georgia. And then they're like, here's a drink, whatever produced from this shoe that is now a liquid now, this is the drink.
Okay, so I'm probably not going to ask you to try the regular lemonade after that. That's what I have next.
Nope.
So, let's see here.
That's all you.
This one's not bad to me. It's a little more lemony than I like my lemonade, but it's closer to what I prefer.
Yeah.
So
that's all you.
This one I'll probably drink afterwards. But all right.
Blackberry tasted like a sour ass. Someone just bent over, dumped the rest of the drink in their ass.
Okay. This one I have no idea about because it's one of those weird energy drinks that I found on the same aisle, because it's one of those things that you always pass by and you wonder vaguely what it must taste like, and that's kind of what this show is about. So let's
I wonder what you taste like.
Surprise point of view change. We're going all midnight screenings on your asses. We started losing daylight, so there really wasn't much else we could do.
No, and I'm using my phone for a flashlight.
Yeah, I mean, we got really gorilla rig camera up here, but let's see.
We got it.
Okay, so as I was saying, this weird, you gotta hear some of this, because it's reach deep into yerba mate culture, and you'll discover people have long gathered to imbibe mate to awaken the mind, perform extraordinary feats, and to exchange confidences. Even Yari, the mythical goddess of mate, decrees it the symbol of friendship. We've always believed there was a magical tree in the rainforest with powers to unite and energize. Come to life with this high-energy infusion brewed from the mighty emerald green mate leaves.
What?
I know mate is like comes from like Argentina. It's like a tea sort of drink. It's just from a different plant. So let's see if it gives us.
You dropped it earlier, so I'm gonna inch away from it.
The mythical mate energy here. Just
can you not open it?
I clipped my fingernails earlier.
Do you want me to open it?
Yeah.
I'm opening it out here. Okay, there you go.
Okay. No spew, thankfully.
Yep.
All right. So let's see, forced you to try something you didn't like before.
Yeah, you try that one first and see how you like it.
Yeah. All right, let's see here. It's basically like, maybe I'm still tasting the lemonade, but it tastes kind of like those berry tea drinks you can get.
Really?
I mean, that's basically what it is. So you have
a first tasting experience that's really good, and mine's just horrid.
It's not good. I mean, it's not my favorite type of drink, but nowhere near as bad as yours was. And I'm sorry, I didn't know you didn't like lemons.
<It's fine>.
Okay.
Okay. Let's try this. Okay.
I'm gonna burn your house down with a lemon.
Okay, let's try it. It smells weird.
It is, but it's called Revelberry, so.
Nope.
No?
No. It tastes like a watered down, like, juice. It tastes like Juicy Juice and it's watered down. That's what it tastes like.
Well, Juicy Juice was already pretty watered down.
I know, that's why I'm just like, it tastes like someone just halved it.
Okay.
Are you gonna dump
it? Well, not yet, but probably should, because it's not my cup of tea, really.
No, it's not.
So let's see here. Now, what's next? We got, I think I've tried one of these Flathead Lake sodas before on here, and this is a different one. Flathead Lake Gourmet Handcrafted Soda. This one's sour cherry. So I think I tried orange and grape before. Yeah, I like cherry soda. I mean, the only reason I discovered Cheerwine was because of this show. So.
Oh, you can twist it off. It says twist off.
Good.
Because you forgot a bottle opener.
Yeah, I forgot a bottle opener because I'm a dumbass.
No, you're not.
Okay, one second. Okay, here we go. Sour cherry. Haven't had a soda like that in a long time.
Mm-mm. Does it smell like cherry medicine or something?
A little bit. I mean, it's basically cheer wine but sour. There's not much else I can say. I mean, again, not my favorite, but mm-hmm. But this one I'd still drink. So,
okay, right, let's your see. Turn. Oh, it's a little dragon. Mm-hmm. That's so cute.
I still don't know why they picked that as their mascot. I mean, does the dragon live in the lake or something?
I don't know. He looks like he's kind of high. This is the type of kid that you knew in high school that you knew was getting into drugs. I mean, look at the design on the thing. You knew that guy was in some good shit. I mean, I'll drink it. Excuse me.
Clearly.
But it's not my favorite.
Again, not too bad. So mm-hmm.
That's okay.
I think I'm gonna save that one if I can put the yeah. There we go. Close enough.
Yeah, you're not gonna save the berry thing.
No.
Okay.
Okay, so after that we only have two sodas left, and okay, this is actually a first because this is a soda that I know that because I've tried it and I know it's good, and I basically used to have this ever since there was this really good Mexican restaurant back when I lived in Arkansas, and they used to have Jarritos and this in their cooler, and that's where I first got it. This is a really good Spanish apple soda called Cidro Monde. I'm not sure how you pronounce it. Anyway, it's an apple soda. I really like it, and I want you to try it.
Okay.
So,
I'm not sure if that's a twist off or it's not a twist off.
It ain't. Okay, so that took forever to do, because. Me being the genius that I am, forgot to bring a bottle opener with me, and I live 20 miles away, so there was no going back for it.
No.
And Katie had to open that by hand.
Yep.
Hey, Katie, there's this great soda I want you to try. Now bleed for it.
Just, yes.
Okay.
God, that
was so. I'm very sorry. I didn't mean to.
You're fine. It was actually comical, and it was funny. I wish we were recording, but as I was opening it up, the last nozzle that made it open, I punched myself in the face. All right, so I'm gonna try this soda, and this soda better be freaking good, Eli.
It is. Trust me.
Okay. You know what? That was definitely worth all that work. Yeah. Look how deep it is.
I was like, you hate it, don't you?
Just no, no, it's actually pretty good.
It really is. I mean, and it's pretty cheap too. About the price of a bottle of Jarritos, and that's very inexpensive soda.
Yeah. Okay, so now that my blood's all over the bottle, you want to try it?
Sure.
It tastes like iron.
It's basically like fizzy apple cider. So you non-alcoholic, but might need some after that.
Yeah.
Okay. The last soda that I have with me to try is one from a very familiar name in internet Let's Try videos. I've tried a couple of sodas from this company before, and I was thinking that there's no way that I would be able to find another flavor from them without actually special ordering it, because most of the sodas that you know of them are the special order kind of get around Thanksgiving. It's Jones Soda. They have they're famous for having the turkey entire Thanksgiving dinner in soda form. Yeah, they make that turkey dressing things.
Oh
yeah, it sounds awful to me too, but. We have one of the more mundane flavors with us, thankfully.
Oh, God.
Because I'd already found a couple of them, orange, berry, and grape. Those are small potatoes compared to most of what Jones has to offer. But here, we have Jones Green Apple. Because...
See, why is that one not a twist on?
I know. Just...
Just the one fucked up... Damn you, Mexico!
Rather ominous the way it's smoking like that. Okay.
It looks like a little potion brewing.
It is, in a way.
It's the green potion from Hocus Pocus. When the guy's, like, taking the shot of, like, the potion, and...
I was gonna say, yes. Are you a virgin, but...
Oh, God. No.
Pepsi. No. Who any virgins? I'm not sure whether I want to leave that in or not.
You should.
Okay, so we have our little green potion here, and you know what? You got to try the last one, so...
Yeah.
What do you say this is the last soda we got to try, so...
Okay.
You can have this one, too.
Aw, thank you.
It's apple, so it shouldn't be that bad.
It's a doggo! Okay, so let's try this. So, it tastes like a green Jolly Rancher.
I mean, green Jolly Ranchers are green apple flavored, so I would imagine, but... Okay, let's see here. Yeah, that really is what it tastes like. It's not much else to say. I mean, I'd still prefer the other apple soda we have, even though that was a lot more work.
Oh, oops.
But, yeah, that's the one that's open, because...
This one.
Ain't no getting that back going.
I mean, if you want extra iron, you can drink this one.
I mean, I'm probably going to drink it later anyway.
Yeah.
But, it's fucking hell. But, yeah, this one wasn't bad either. I mean, Jones Soda certainly has worse sodas to offer out there. So, let's see here.
Got any Band-Aids in your car?
No, but I've got some napkins.
No, you're fine.
Okay. So, that's all of the sodas, but we're actually not done yet. Because
nope.
Because I actually brought some candies that I've never tried either. This time we got a couple of them. And in this case, we've got... Okay, first one. Okay, so these are chocolates that I always saw when I was working at Walgreens previously, and I never decided to try. So this time, I figured why not, because... So we've got some Brookside Dark Chocolate.
Ooh.
We got a couple of different kinds. This one is pomegranate, and she's got blueberry. I'm actually not that familiar with pomegranate flavor. I think I've had it once before, but it was a long time ago. But that combined with dark chocolate, never been huge chocolate and fruit guy. So, okay. Definitely smells sour a little bit.
Ew.
Not as sour as the other one. Thank
you. God.
Okay. So let's see what this is like. It basically tastes like one of those chocolate-covered raisins, only less chewy.
Really?
Mm-hmm. I mean, it's not as grapey, obviously, but it's still got the pretty much the same taste to it.
That smells weird.
I mostly taste the dark chocolate.
You know what? I was going to bite it in half and show you guys, but the fruit's in there.
Mm.
In my mouth right now. It tastes like it tastes like a raisin.
Yeah, that's kind of anticlimactic. I mean, I thought, compared to what we tasted before now, just...
No. Yeah, that one's a... Nah.
I mean...
With
it's,
me.
I wouldn't say it's worth, like, the $3.50 I paid for it, but...
You paid for $3.50?
Just... It's really kind of anticlimactic compared to what I was thinking it was going to be. So I guess sometimes it's good to stick with the candy you know instead.
Yeah, because I wasn't really shocked by it. I wasn't.
I made a mistake just now, actually. It's not just blueberry. It's acai and blueberry.
Oh, what's acai? Like, kamehameha. Blueberry.
No, it kind of like one of those. It's one of those hipster superfoods that you hear talked about all the time. Supposed to improve your dieting and stuff like that.
I'm on a Kai diet.
basically.
Like, it's a cleanse. I'm only gonna eat nothing but acai fruit.
Okay, I like blueberries. So this one has a better chance of being, but the other drinks that I've had that have acai in them, they weren't that good. So let's take a taste. Okay, so I did taste the blueberry on this one. Honestly, this one's not bad.
Really?
Definitely tastes a lot more like a blueberry than the other one did. I mean, the other one tasted like pomegranate, but...
Wow, that one tastes a lot better.
Yeah, I agree. I mean, it's not
I like that one.
Yeah. So, this one is actually pretty enjoyable. I mean, I still probably wouldn't go out of my way to get it.
Yeah.
The candy has been pretty good so far, thankfully. Now, the last thing that we have, because chocolate and fruit wasn't enough already, we've got another one. We've got some Pim's Orange Chocolate Cookies. No, my apologies. They're biscuits, not cookies.
Oh, it's a little biscuit. Would you like some crappy tea? Where's the energy drink tea? Did you chuck it?
No, I poured it out.
Oh.
Just hearing Chris screaming, they're called cookies, damn it.
Yay, sorry, okay. Blackout.
Okay, so now we have, I wonder if Pim used these cookies to take over the world and fill of the future.
I don't know, it looks like a wafer, like a vanilla wafer.
It really is. I mean, I've had similar cookies to this. I think there was something like this in the international candy package I tried previously, but this is a different flavor. So,
what's it taste like?
Chocolate and orange do not go well together.
Really? Let me see. Let me try it.
No. I mostly taste the orange. There's a chocolate aftertaste there.
Why does it feel spongy in here? Oh my god! God, it feels spongy! Oh my god!
Because the cookie's soft.
It feels spongy! Oh, I was touching the edge and it was like crumbling. It felt like a sponge. It looks like one of those like toy cookies, you know what I'm talking about? Those little like toy cookies that you had like with the kitchen set and when you were a kid? Yeah, it looks like that.
Yeah, it's like I said, chocolate and orange does not taste well together. It's just...
It's not that. It's just... I was not expecting it to be a soft cookie. It was spongy. Like, it... No, like, I was getting my mind ready for something new, and I'm like, okay, it's a cookie. It's gonna be hard, and I bit into it. It was like a sponge. I mean, it's okay. Like, I like the dark chocolate and the orange, but the cookie... It could be a better type of cookie. Like,
really?
Yeah, I do like the orange and the cookie, or the dark chocolate mix, but all together it did not taste right.
So you liked that more than I did. All right.
Yeah, but I did not like the sponge part. The sponge part, mm-mm.
That's an interesting twist.
A little bit, yeah.
Well, but with that being said, this has been another edition of The Hero of Tasting featuring Gigglescar. Go check out her channel, and until we meet next time... And next time I'll be in a different place. Then, well, I'll see you on the other side of the aisle.
Bye, guys!